Hi, my name is Søren Olsen, and in this video, we'll look at images and take a quick look again at draworder and then some scripts we have available. So, a skeleton is made up of images attached to bones, but Spine does not edit the images, so you will need to use your own image editing software to create the art for your skeletons. The first step to setting up a skeleton is to bring in each image as a region attachment, which is a simple rectangular image that is attached to a bone. But before region attachments can be created, Spine needs to know where to find the images. So, the images node over here in the tree stores a path, as you can see here, to a folder where Spine will look for images for the skeleton. The path for images can be set either relative to where the project file is saved, or you can set an absolute path. Currently, it doesn't have a path set, and that means it will be using wherever the project is saved. As you can see here, it says project. Now, since I don't have my project saved, I'm just going to quickly do that. Go here, click Save Project As, go to my Spine Example folder, and I'm just going to save it in here. I'm going to call it Temp Spine and replace it. Overwrite it. There we go. And now, if I expand this Images node, you can see I have the Export and Images folder. Now, I want to be using this Images folder, so I'm going to go down here and just type in Images, like so. And now the images will show up in the images node here. Spine will watch the folder and immediately load any changes to the image files if you change the files themselves. So with the images now visible under the images node, you can drag the images out into the edit area and Spine will automatically create a slot and place the attachment or the image below this. We can also take multiple images at the same time. So I just select one of them, hold down Shift, and then I have multiple selected. I can also hold down Command and select individually and then just drag them in. Now you can see we have multiple slots, each with an image attached to it under the root bone. You can also add the images to bones by selecting here and then clicking the set parent and then choosing where you want it. Or you can also just press P, which is a shortcut to set parent. You can see it opens this pick session, and we click the bone. And it asks me if I want to use an existing slot or a new slot. I'm just gonna click cancel here. We can also do like this, take an image here and then drag it onto an existing slot. And now this slot will have two different images on, but like I mentioned in the previous video, only one attachment can be visible at any given time on a single slot. Also notice if you look here on the images node, that some of these icons here are green and some of them are red, and this the green one means that they are being used in the project, while the red one means that they are not yet being used. So once you have all your region attachment created, then scale, rotation and translation tools can be used to assemble the skeleton, so you can move all these different images into place. And I'll be explaining how to use these tools in the next video. Spine will find the image for an attachment by taking the path that we have specified here under the images node, and then append the attachment name. This is the attachment name. The attachment does not need to include a file extension. Spine will automatically look for PNG and JPEG files. So, if I go down here and I change this path, like so, you can see that the attachment that I have defined up here is no longer being shown. But if I double click this to rename it, I can go in here and I can type images/head. And now it is looking in a folder called images for a file called head. And you can see here we have images and we have a folder here called images. Now if I go here and change this back to images, like it was before, the attachment will again be missing. So I'm going to double click this and remove the path, and now the image is showing again. An attachment name can also include subfolders. For example, if I am using this path, images, I could have a folder in here called, for example, red, and I could go here and I could double click and type in like so, and I could have a specific version of the head where he has red hair, for example, and this would be placed in a subfolder under this node. If an attachment has a path set, the path is used to find the image instead of the attachment name. You can see the path down here. So I could go here and I could type head. And you can see, despite the path up here being red slash head, it is using the path down here. Two attachments under the same slot cannot have the same name, but they can have the same path. I'll quickly go over daughter again, despite covering it slightly in the previous video, and I'll be using the good old Spineboard project for this. So the order of which attachments are drawn is defined over here in the drawer node, and slots higher up in the list are drawn on top of those below. The slots can be either dragged, like so, or you can select them and then hit the minus and plus keys on your keyboard. You can also hold down shift, and you can see I'm holding down shift and I'm pressing plus and minus, and it's jumping by 5 instead of just 1. You can also select multiple slots, and you can see I'm now moving 3 different slots at the same time. And again, now I'm holding down shift and I'm hitting plus minus. Another way to change the draw order is to use the filter buttons that we have available up here in the top of the tree. And I'm gonna hide the bones and attachments. And now you can see we have a slightly different icon here. You see, if this is the draw order node before, and this is the draw order node now. We can change the draw order just like we did before by dragging it. The benefit of this is that now, if I'm working with a very large skeleton with lots of bones and lots of attachments, it can be a bit tricky to find which slot an image is attached to. But now, if I click this gun here, you can see that it selects the slot and not the attachment. Well, if I have the attachments on and I select the gun again, you can see that now it selects the attachment. If I take this off again, select it, and instantly I have the slot selected and I can change the draw order of it. I've now switched over to Photoshop to demonstrate one of the scripts we have available. When creating skeleton images using an image editing program outside of Spine, it's very common to create images on separate layers, as you can see I've done here. I have all these different layers with different parts of Spine Boy, and for example, if I hide the head here, you can see that this part is no longer shown. So let me put this back on. Now, exporting all of these layers manually by first trimming them to get rid of white space and then saving each layer individually is very time consuming, and you will then also have to manually place them inside of Spine. And this would be double work because, as you can see, he's already posed as I want him to look in my setup pose inside of Spine. To save time, we've included a script that will not only export each visible layer in Photoshop, but also export a JSON file that you can then import into Spine, and your images will then be in the correct position. You can find the scripts if you go here. You can see I have my Macintosh hard drive here. I have applications, Spine, and then this is where I've installed Spine. Now inside of here, I have a scripts folder. You can see in here, we have GIMP, Illustrator, and Photoshop scripts. If you're not sure you're using the latest version of the script, you can go to a website, then go to documentation, go to user guide under images here, and we're gonna scroll down here to scripts. You can see here it says that the script can be found in the spine installation folder in the script subfolder, and the latest version of these scripts can always be found here. And then if I scroll further down, you can see we also have links for Illustrator, GIMP, and even After Effects. To use the Photoshop script, the images that make up the skeleton should be on separate layers, like I mentioned before, and like the setup I have here. This is also true if you're using GIMP. Now, as I also mentioned before, when the script is run, it will export each layer as a separate image file and then create a JSON file that can be imported into Spine. I'll show you how this import is done in a bit. But first, let me go over the settings for the Photoshop script. Now, the first thing I've done here is I've actually bound the script to a hotkey. So if I hit F5 on my keyboard, it will launch the script. Now, to do that, you need to place the script file in the correct position. So, or the correct location. So what I've done is I found my Photoshop directory here, and I've gone to presets. And in here we have another folder called scripts. And if you place the layers to png.jsx file in there, it will then show up. If you go to edit and then keyboard shortcuts that I have open now, and then you go here to file, scroll down all the way down to scripts. And you can see we have layers to png showing up here and my shortcut for it. So I'm just gonna hit cancel like so. And then F5. So all these different settings we have in here, let me just go over them. The first one will write layers as PNG files. And this just means that all these layers we have over here, it will write them out as a separate file. So for example, the head layer here would be called head.png, and front shin will be called front shin.png, so on. The next setting we have is write a template PNG, and this means that all the visible layers we have, or all the layers we have depending on this ignore hidden layers here, will be written as a single image that you can then use to as a template inside a spine when you're placing your images. Now, the write spine JSON setting here just means that it will output a JSON file that we can import into Spine, and it will then look through everything we have imported and place the images correctly. Now we have the ignore hidden layers setting here. This also just means that layer, like for example these two here, will be ignored when I hit OK. The use groups as skins setting will, if I have over here my layers, if I'm using groups to set up my layers, it will create a skin with the same name as your group, and it will then place your different images in the subfolder for the different skins. This use ruler origin as 0.0. This means it will take this ruler position here. For example, if I place it here, this will now be the root position of my images. Now, let me open up here again. Now, the PNG scale percentage I have here, I can take this to 1% or 100%. This means that, you can see if I zoom in, it's actually rather large images that I'm working with. And I prefer to work at high resolution when I'm creating the assets. So now, when I export it, this would of course be way too large for a game. So when I export it, I turn this down to a different scale, and it will scale the images before actually exporting it. The padding setting we have here will give you some extra room to work with. For example, the head here, if I set the padding to 0, it would trim all the white space just to the very edge of the images or the pixels on that layer. If you're working with meshes, it's a very good idea to set this padding up because it will give you a little more room to work with. And this can also avoid aliasing artifacts for opaque pixels along the image edge. Now, the output directory, I've set this to images spine boy temp. I'm just going to add a slash here. And this is where my images will be exported to. The JSON path, I'm going to leave this blank because I've saved the spine boy PSD file in the same folder as where I have my project file. So I'm just going to hit OK. And I'm going to let the script run here and let it finish. And when it's done, I'll then switch into Spine. So I've switched back into Spine again now, and you can see I've opened up the temp project that I created before. And now I want to get the images that I've created in Photoshop into Spine. To do this, I click the Spine logo up here and I go to Import Data, click Browse, and then I find the Spine Boy JSON file that I exported from Photoshop. I hit Open. Now it asked me for a skeleton name. I'm just going to leave it at Spine Boy. Hit OK. And now you can see it's created a new skeleton. I can delete this one here. I'm just going to do this. And if I go to the images node, you can see the path that I defined before, images/spineboy temp, is being used. And all the images are now placed in the correct draw order based on what I had in Photoshop, and they all have an attachment and they're all named based on the layer naming convention that I used inside of Photoshop. So this was a pretty long video, but I hope you learned something. In the next video, we will start taking a look at the tools we have available for Spine, and I hope to see you there. So thank you very much for watching. Bye for now.